Good morning, friends. This is our English period, and we are going to learn one very great lesson, which will give us more information about one of the part of our India. Already, we are learning the lessons in that the glimpses of India. In that, already we have learned two lessons. First one is Abeka from Goa, and second one is Coorg. And we have learned much information regarding these two places. Goa and Coorg. We have seen that those places have their great significance, and when we have learned that lesson, we feel that we should go for outing on at those places. So now today we are going to learn one lesson. Before that, I want to ask you some question. When we wake up in the morning, what we do? Normally we do our whatever work and then we go for the tea. Or any guest comes in our house, then we ask him or her, will you take tea or coffee? So most probably around 99% we welcome our guest with a tea. So tea has a very important place in our daily routine. Tea is a integral part of our life. Right now or nowadays, youngsters are not drinking tea. They drink some different, like Horlicks or Complan or something different. But if we see the past, or our father, grandfather, they always prefer tea. And in Marathi it says, "Chaha hai, Maharashtra sa amrut hai." Like that, tea is there. So tea has a very key factor, or tea is a very integral part of our country. Then from where we get the tea, that we are going to learn. So the name of the lesson is Tea from Assam. Most probably you know very well, because you already learned in geography Assam is famous for the tea plantation. So that glimpses of India, we are going to learn this lesson, a tea from Assam, by Arup Kumar Datta. If we think about Arup Kumar Datta, he is an Indian writer and he is a journalist. Nothing more information about him, but he is a great Indian writer. He has written much literature in Indian literature, and he is a journalist. Okay, this is the speciality of this Arup Kumar Datta. Now we are going to learn this lesson. In this lesson, we will go to listen or introduce two characters. First one is Pranjol and second one is Rajveer. Both are classmates and learning in Delhi. And Pranjol invited Rajveer in summer vacation. Okay. Pranjol lives in Assam, and he invited Rajveer to his destination, means in Assam. And their journey started, and then we will see what exactly happened and how we get fascinated, how Rajveer get fascinated towards Assam, that we are going to learn. The name of the lesson is Tea from Assam. So introduction is given here. Pranjol, a youngster from Assam, is Rajveer's classmate at school in Delhi. Pranjol's father is the manager of a tea garden in Upper Assam, and Pranjol has invited Rajveer to visit his home during the summer vacation. This is the introduction. We'll see that these two characters are there in the lesson. Pranjol and Rajveer are classmates, those who are learning in or studying in Delhi. Pranjol has invited Rajveer in the summer vacation to his destination, where he lives. Pranjol lives in Assam. So now their journey started, because it's a summer vacation, and they started to Assam. Chai garam chai, a vendor called out in a high pitched voice. And suppose we travel by the train, then we see that how those people come and they sell tea or coffee, or sometimes different things, bread or something like that. So this time chai wala has come, and he has ordered with his high pitched sound said, "Chai garam garam chai," a vendor called out in a high pitched voice. He came up to their window and asked, "Chai sahab, give us two cup," Pranjol said. And it was morning time, and that is why Pranjol said, "Yes, two cups, give us two cups." And they sipped the steaming hot liquid. Which is a steaming hot liquid? Tea. Almost everyone in the compartment was drinking tea too. Already I have previously I told you that tea is a beverage. Beverage means what? The liquid which we drink other than water. So this is everybody's favorite. So we start our day with the tea. Like that they have started their day, means maybe morning, with the tea. Almost all the people, those who are sitting in the compartment or boarding in the compartment, they all were having tea. Do you know that our 80 crore cups of tea and are drunk every day throughout the world? Can you imagine how many 80 crore cups of tea people drink in a day all over the world? Raju said, "Wow!" exclaimed Pranjo. Tea really is very popular, and there will not be a single person who doesn't know tea. Everybody knows tea because tea is very famous, and that is why 80 crore people all over the world drink tea. So this is the amazing statistic we can understand. The train pulled out the station again. Train started. Pranjol buried his nose in his detective book again. And Pranjol has a great hobby to read some detective books. And again, now whatever two, three sentences they have spoken, and again he started reading his detective book. Rajveer too was an ardent fan of detective story. Ardent means very enthusiastic. Rajveer also likes to read in this detective stories. But now he is moving towards Assam. This place is new for him, and that is why he is trying to see, he is trying to witness, he is trying to capture all the scenario, all the scenery, all the location, geographical location, whatever he could see from the window that he is seeing. That is why he is not taking interest in reading the detective stories. Raju too was an ardent fan of detective story, but at the moment he was keener on looking at the beautiful scenery. As I told you, it was green everywhere, and you know that green plantation, tea green plantation we see in the Assam. And similarly, when we go in Uti or Assam, then we like to see those. We go there, we have some pictures, we have some selfies in the tea plantation, because something different we see. Because when some people come in Konkan region, they have a certain different point of view, and they take the pictures, they enjoy this atmosphere, but we don't. Like that, Pranjal was not enjoying, because it was not familiar, unfamiliar for him. But Rajveer was very interested in that. He was keen observer, exactly, because he was looking something different. He is getting something different there. It was green everywhere. Rajveer had never seen so much greenery before. And you know, the person who is living in Delhi, where concrete buildings are there, concrete jungle is there, we can't see. I mean, suppose those who are living in metropolitan cities, they don't get to see such type of greenery. They don't get a fortunate to see the nature, jungle. And that is why when he see that, he really becomes so happy. And that is why he was just fascinated towards that scenery, green everywhere. And because he hasn't seen that before, it was unprecedented for him. Then the soft green paddy field gave way to the tea bushes. It was a magnificent view against the backdrop of densely wooded hills. A sea of tea bushes stretched as far as the eye could see, and he was looking all the scenario, all the nature, all the surroundings there. Dropping the tiny tea plants were tall, sturdy shade trees, and amidst the older rows of the bushes, busily moved doll-like the figures. And you know that tea plantation was under the big shady tree, and it was looking like a something like doll-like figures, those plantation. In this in the distance was an ugly building with the smoke billowing out of tall chimneys. Ugly building means one factory will be there. So in the distance he has seen one ugly building, because just see, actually building is not ugly, but it is trying to hamper the atmosphere. That is why writer has said ugly building, which has with the smoke billowing out of the chimneys, and smoke, and that is why smoke emits from the factories. Like that it was, that is why it is said ugly building. Hey, a tea garden, Rajveer cried excitedly. And he has seen, and first time in his life he has seen tea garden. Before that only he has drunk tea. He drunk cups of teas. But now he has seen the plantation of the tea, and that is why he was so excited, and he screamed with the excitement, "Oh, hey, a tea garden!" Ranjur, who had been born and brought up on the plantation, didn't share Rajiv's excitement because it was not new for him. That is why he hasn't taken that enjoyment in his in the tea garden. He just look at and he has not given that identical excitement to Rajivir. "Oh, this is a tea country now," he said. "Assam has the largest concentration of the plantation in the world." And if you see Assam always known for the tea plantation, and that is why it is the largest concentration of the tea plant in the world. You will see enough garden to last you a lifetime, and this is the beginning. You will see many tea gardens in the Assam. "I have been reading as much as I could about tea," Rajiv said. "No one really knows who discovered tea, but there are many legends." And he said he might be fascinated towards the tea because the tea might be his favorite beverage. And that is why he used to read more, but now actually he is seeing that teas, and that is why he was very fascinated. And what he said, "No one really knows who discovered tea, and now we also don't know. Only we know how to drink tea with adrak and ginger and everything. We put in the tea and we sip the tea every morning or in the evening with some biscuits and breads. We have tea. But we never try to discover who has invented tea. So there are many legends, many stories are there." "What legends?" "Well, there is a one about the Chinese emperor who always boiled water before drinking it. Nowadays we are drinking water when it is boiled one, okay? Because we want germ-free water. Even though we have pure heat than water purifier, but most common practices which we had done since many years, that is we boil water and then we get it cool and then we drink water. And similarly, Chinese emperor who always boil water before drinking it, one day a few leaves of the things burning under the pot fell into the water, giving it a delicious flavor. And he was boiling the water and some leaves had been dropped in that boiling water, and then when he had drunk that particular water, it has given a delicious taste flavor. It is said that they were tea leaves, and then he understood, he discovered that these are the tea leaves. Tell me another, scoffed Pranjal. Pranjal again said another story. "We have an Indian legend too, Bodh Dharma, an ancient Buddhist ascetic, cut off his eyelids because he felt sleepy during the meditation." You know, Buddhism, and they have monk. So whenever they use for the meditation, when they sit for the meditation, one of the fellow used to get sleep, and that is why he cut his eyelids. Then a tea plant grew out of the eyelids, and then what happened? At the eyelids, a tree plantation grew up. The leaves of this plant, when put in the hot water and drunk, banished his sleep. And then when he put those leaves in the hot water, then it become tea and banished the sleep. He didn't sleep afterwards. These are the two stories we have learned. They that Rajivir knows. Tea was first drunk in China. Okay, so it is the China, that is why chini, we say chini. So it is first drunk in the China. Rajivir added, "As far back as 2700 BC before Christ, in fact, words such as tea, chini or chai are from Chinese. Tea came to Europe only in the 16th century. Okay, and was drunk more as medicine than a beverage. And before that, it was not a beverage. It was not the liquid to drink. It was something like medicine, which banished the sleep, which make us a little active. For that sake, people used to drink tea. The train clattered into the Mariani Junction. The boys collected their luggage and pushed their way to the crowded platform, and they just completed their journey. They are at the their station, and that is why they have taken their luggage and put out themselves. French were manifest waiting for them. Soon they were driving towards the Dekebari, the tea garden managed by Pranjul's father. And if we see what is the profession of Pranjul's father, he was a manager in the tea garden in Upper Assam. An hour later, the car veered, moved sharply off the main road. They crossed a cattle bridge and entered Dekebari tea estate. And where they have gone? Dekebari tea estate. On both sides of the gravel road, gravel means not properly made pakka road, okay, pakka road. It was gravel road where acre upon acre of the tea bushes, and what he has seen, means a vast land of the tea bushes he had seen there, all neatly pawned to the same height, group of tea pluckers with the bamboo basket on their back, wearing plastic aprons, were plucking the newly sprouted leaves. And what they were doing, we see that. If we see the picture of Assam, we see that some women standing in that particular plantation and having one bamboo basket at the back, and they are plucking the tea leaves there. Okay, so what exactly we do? We collect the tea leaves for the tea. Okay, that Rajveer has seen. Ranju's father showed down to allow a tractor pulling a trailer load of the tea leaves to pass, and then Pranjul father had shown some friendly nature, that one tractor was coming, that is why he had given some a place to overtake him. This is the second flush of sprouting period. First means second, means like that, we cut the mango or we cut some vegetables, and then some vegetables are there which suppose we cut once time, and then again one time again it grows, again we get the same crop. So what he said, this is the second flush of the sprouting period, isn't it, Mr. Barua? Rajveer asked. It lasts from May to July and yield the best tea. So May to July yield the best tea. You seem to have done your homework before coming, Pranjul's father said in surprise. And when he said something about the tea plantation, tea, then Pranjul's father becomes so fascinated towards his knowledge, and then he asks, you have done much study about the tea plantation, and already we have experienced that he had a certain interest in the tea, that is why he has read about, because he had told two stories about the introducing of the tea, the China story and one of the Buddhist monk. Yes, Mr. Prabhuja, Rajveer admitted, but I hope to learn much more while I am here. And he was very interested in the tea, that is why he said, okay, I have read more, but I want to learn practically here, and now as I am here, so I will learn more practically in this area. So this is what the tea from Assam lesson said. What exactly we have seen? There are two characters in the story, Pranjul and Rajveer, both are classmates, those who are learning in the Delhi. And then Pranjul invited Rajveer to his place, that is Assam. And they started at the beginning, we see that Chai Wala has come and he has asked Chai Garam. Then they have taken two cups of tea, and then that time he understood that around 80 crores of people all over the world are drinking tea regularly per day. So tea has a great history that Rajveer has introduced, that how tree has there are two legend with two stories are there. First one is the Chinese emperor used to drink boiled water. Once what happened, that some leaves put into the mistakenly put in the boiled water, and then when he has drunk that water, that time he had got one very delicious flavor, and then he started that. And another one, that one of the Buddhist monk used to get sleep, that time he has just cut his eyelid, and then after that from the eyelid some leaves have grown up, then with those leaves he put in the water, and then he never get the sleep, that his sleep is banished. So that whatever story we have learned in that story, afterwards they reached to the Assam, and before eventually similarly Rajveer was looking from the window the scenario of the Assam, then he has seen how the plantations are there, how the people are plucking the leaves of the tree, that everything he has seen. And at the end, he has exhibited his knowledge about the tea, whatever he has read. And that is why Pancho's father asked him, "You have done much study about the Assam and tea plantation." Then he said, "Yes, but I want to take some practical knowledge from this place. So I am here. So I will get more knowledge." So I think you have understood the lesson very neatly. And if any question will come, then you will write it very effectively, because tea is the integral part of our life. So till then, just write down the flowchart of the lesson and try to read it again and again. So till then, thank you. Thank you very much.